and I have the unique pleasure of presenting the Student Leader Award to Jerron Corley. I met Jerron 2 years ago at his alma mater, Parkway West High School. I was placed there as a teaching artist about a week after I was hired by Hartwell. Truth be told, I was fresh off the decision to pursue writing and its teaching as a professional career, which meant I had no idea what I was doing. Jerron definitely knew what he was doing. An initially soft-spoken student, he quickly became my go-to in the coming months, teaching me what a true teacher-to-student relationship looked like, even if I didn't know it. An Artwell alumni himself of over 5 years, the first thing Jerron taught me was the gift of multitasking. At such a young age, he was already a writer, an advisor to other students, an entrepreneur, starting his own business called Jay's Comfort Cookies, which you should ask him about, and a leader in his community. It was from these traits that flowed a unique dedication to others, an authenticity to his craft, and a focus unparalleled in any student I had before or after I met him. Jerron, you asked me your senior year if I could be your mentor for your senior project, and because of my hectic schedule already being in college, I wasn't able to offer you as much as I wanted to. But I want you to know that every accomplishment you tell me of and every story I read about through him, through social media, is a testament to your impact on my life and the impact you continue to have on those around you. We should all strive to reflect your heart, your voice, and your ideals. There is no question that you are the perfect recipient for this award.
Hi, I'm Cathy Cohen. All of the young poets we are lucky to work with at Artwell are unique and inspiring, but it gives me special pride to speak of Jerron tonight. Jerron joined our weekly Visionary Poets group a few years back. His teacher, Gino Nicholas, confided that this student, who might seem a little quiet at first, was quite talented. How right he was. Jerron, your old soul and your sure voice soon were communicated to the group each week through your brilliant poems. I love to watch you create. You seem to channel lyrics from the universe, focusing deeply for a long time, then you scribble lines down on the page real fast. Your poems were and are important, concerned with personal and social issues, often taking up others' perspectives, and always compassionate. While browsing recently through some of your high school work, I was touched by something you wrote about conflict and reconciliation, even as a ninth grader. Please forgive me quoting out of context. Who's to blame for the earth shattering like a broken mirror on the wall? Or your heart, after it has borne too much pain, to stop its long, dark fall? We should join in and help. For we may have been formidable foes, but in the end, no person or place should suffer. It's been a gift to work with you, Jerron. I'm very proud to know you and look forward to learning from your wise and compassionate words in the future, be they written, spoken, or sung. Thanks.
Story that just happened not so long ago. Just a few weeks ago, I was asked by my African-American history professor, Dr. Edmonds, to write a letter to a family member or a friend that has made an impact in my life and to thank them for what they have done for me up to this point. So I decided to write to my father, Clayton Corley Sr. I knew this would be something that he would not expect, for most of our communication consisted of text messages, weekly phone calls while I'm away at school, and FaceTime sessions. And yet, as I was writing, something sparked within me, a feeling like no other. It was a mix of nostalgia and sincerity. It brought me back to days of writing anonymous get well cards for breast cancer survivors, or back in grade school when you would write candy grams for your friends and everyone in the classroom. By crafting this letter, it solidified my belief that writing is so much more than just a hobby. It's an art that, as stated in the words of my father, Dr. Edmonds, Miss Cathy, and everyone here at Artwell, is being lost. It's being erased from our education systems. There are schools that aren't even teaching children to write cursive anymore, and rather introducing them to technology and teaching them how to type. Well, in my opinion, and for those of you that have iPhones or Androids, and I don't really think a kiss emoji means I love you.
Oh.
I think actually taking the time to write with a pen or a pencil saying, I love you. That in itself brings a powerful message. It hurts to see such a sacred art becoming lost to the children. And that is the reason why that I have dedicated myself to proving to people that there is indeed power in the pen. As I receive this award, I give thanks to my family who is in presence tonight, for they have given me 19 years and counting of everlasting love and support. I give thanks to Artwell for putting together this amazing night of celebration known as the Artwell Awards and honoring me as a leader of students that dedicate themselves to changing the community through their love of the arts. But most of all, I give thanks to the glory of God for that in these times of trial and tribulation, I am certain that I can do all things through He who strengthens me. Before I leave this podium for the night, I would like to present a piece of spoken word that represents a message to our youth, a declaration of reclamation that I like to call Educate and Elevate. Please enjoy. Educate and elevate. Tell that to the man on the street with no home, no family, no food to eat. Take his hand, look in his eyes. They tell stories of men whose lives are on the line. Educate and elevate. Say that to the woman in the cubicle who foresees better dreams, yet is told that her six-sided jail cell will forever be a reality. Educate and elevate. We must tell our youth. There's more to life than cookies and apple juice. Just look outside the sandbox and beyond the jungle gyms. I'm sure you'll find a way to sweet succulent success. Educate and elevate. Now it is our time to awake and stay woke on the four-word way of life that we have bestowed to the writers, the speakers, the artists crazy enough to believe that they can create change. Educate and elevate. Educate and elevate. To live by such words is to realize that change must not be compromised, but realized. I write to educate and elevate. I speak to educate and elevate. I live to educate and elevate, so that others may retrieve remnants of revolution and rise to the occasion. I bestow upon you all the power to educate and elevate. Thank you.